3 pro tips for selling wine, spirits, or pretty much anything else to restaurants. Coming up next. Hello, everyone, and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Ben Salisbury. Our consulting agency helps wineries and craft distilleries improve their sales strategy and their sales process. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Feel free to share it, and don't forget to subscribe. Selling to restaurants is very different than selling to a traditional retailer, such as a package store or a grocery store. And there's a lot of mystery around how to be successful calling on restaurants, which is the purpose of this video. Now, while there are many different strategies that you need to be successful selling to restaurants, I'm going to cover 3 main categories today. One is the special and very unique needs that restaurants have, especially the buyers who work in restaurants. The second thing is how to tailor your sales approach to this specific type of customer. And the third is how to add real business value to the relationship. If you can do these 3 things really well, you're going to be well on your way to having success selling your wine or spirits brands to restaurants. One thing I'm not going to mention is how important it is to have product knowledge and how you need to go load up on all these certifications. Those things are compulsory. You need to do those things. But they're not the difference makers in why a restaurant would use one person's wine over another, or why a restaurant would use one particular vodka brand over another. So let's get on with the 3 pro tips. Pro tip number 1, you need to understand the special and unique challenges that restaurants have versus other types of buyers of wine and spirits. To the degree you're able to do that, you're going to be a lot more successful. So let me just quickly run through what some of these unique and special challenges are. First of all, working in a restaurant means you're going to be very busy. You have to place a very high premium on the buyer's time. Part of how you do that is you don't show up during busy service times, whether that's lunch or dinner. They're not going to be receiving you when it's convenient for you. You're going to have to tailor your approach to when it's convenient for them. Restaurants, people work very odd hours. And so you really got to be in tune with how time crunched these people are. You don't have that environment in a package store or a grocery store. You don't have a lunch rush or a dinner rush or a line out the door or people running around trying to serve customers live. You do have a certain level of service in package stores and grocery stores. Don't get me wrong, but it's a special level of service that takes place in a restaurant. Another big challenge for restaurants is they have very limited storage. Most restaurants will take 1 or 2 deliveries a week because they just don't have enough storage to stock a week's worth of goods. And so this presents special challenges to them. And you, as the seller of goods, needs to understand that and factor that into your approach with them. Another unique thing about restaurants is the people who make decisions at restaurants, that isn't their primary job. A lot of these people are busy with creating the schedule for the servers and bartenders. They're busy doing inventory. They're busy, receiving the wine order for the week or the liquor order for the week. There's just a lot of things they have to do inside their restaurant, as opposed to other types of off-premise retailers where buying and selling is the role. And that's pretty much what they do. For restaurateurs, the buying of wine and spirits is just one small part of a wide array of jobs that they have to do. And the third thing you really need to understand about restaurants is there are 3 things that are important to all restaurants, and you must really learn and appreciate what these 3 things are and how you might use them to enhance what you have to offer. Here are the 3 things. They want to grow revenue. The restaurant business is a very low margin business, and more revenue takes care of a lot of things. They've got certain fixed costs that have to be covered, and once those fixed costs are covered, everything else contributes towards profit. So maximizing revenue is a big, important thing. So be thinking about how your product can help them do that. The other thing is controlling costs. Contrary to what people think, it's not always about lowering the cost. It's controlling costs. Restaurants plan their costs very carefully into their menu prices. And what they can't tolerate is any kind of variance. So be sensitive to that. And the third thing there is that restaurants want is guest satisfaction. They want to please and delight their guests. Here's an area where selling wine and spirits can really help, because hopefully you're bringing them products that will please and surprise their guests. I have another video that really dives into this, which I'll put a link in the description. You can check that out. Pro tip number two is to tailor your selling approach to the special needs of a restaurant, as mentioned in point number one. So let me dive into this just a little bit. The first thing you can do to tailor your approach is don't act like a salesperson. The more you act like a salesperson, the less you're going to sell. Nobody likes to be approached in a traditional salesperson manner, which is, here's my products, I'm going to sell you today, I'm going to pitch and talk about my product until you buy. This is just a horrible approach. You really need to approach it more as a business partner. You're there to prioritize their needs over yours. In fact, prioritizing their needs over yours is one of the single biggest things you can do to be successful in a restaurant, which means you're going to have to do your homework. You're going to have to really understand what that particular restaurant is facing. Is their business doing well? If so, why and what's working, what's not? There's lots of things you can do to investigate and do some pre-work, some homework ahead of time before you approach any of the buyers in a particular restaurant. Another way to tailor your sales approach is to keep your focus very narrow. This kind of goes to the point I mentioned previously, which is to respect people's time. Don't bring in 10, 12 different things and spread them out on the table and have them taste through them. This shows an incredible lack of respect for people's time. It also puts a lot of work on their shoulders to kind of sort through all the offerings you've brought. If you've done your homework and you know what you want to focus on, keep that focus very narrow. This won't be the only opportunity you're going to have to present to these people, but it really will help a lot if you keep your focus to just two or three things max that you want to talk about that day. Another important part about tailoring your approach to the special and unique needs of restaurants is you need to be looking for ways to add value to the business relationship. And that is the subject of point number three. Add real value to the business relationship. If your focus is on adding value to the business relationship, you're going to sell more product than you ever thought possible. I know it's a subtle twist in the mindset, but it is a powerful twist. And it may take some practice if you've never been trained properly in how to sell to a restaurant. So how do you add value to the business relationship for a restaurant? Well, the first thing is to help them stay up to speed with trends. If you have ever worked in a restaurant, you don't have time for anything. You don't have time to research and read the daily trade press and keep up with what's going on. So you can be a big asset to them. You should spend time reading the trade press. You should, clip articles or summarize, the day's news or the week's news about what's trending in wine and spirits, and summarize it in a very single, a single sheet of paper that you could leave behind. These restaurant buyers are too busy to keep up with trends, most of them. And so you can be a real friend to them, a real asset to them by just giving them a digest of what's going on in the wine business. And not just trends for the business in general, but trends in their neighborhood, trends in their area. What are other people doing that's working? Believe me, restaurants are very interested in what other people are doing. They just don't have time to go investigate. You can be the person to provide that for them. So sharing relevant trends to them is a great way to add value. The single biggest way to add value is just be dependable, be accessible. It's shocking how many salespeople can't be found when they're needed. And because restaurants have very little time, they're going to make calls to the people that know they can reach. They know who are going to call back right away, who are going to have answers to their questions. If you strive to be that person, the go-to person, then you're going to really sell a lot of wine. Because really, selling wine to restaurants is more about service, dependability, and trust than it is about your product knowledge or what items you have in your portfolio. The real key to selling a lot of product to restaurants is being that super dependable, trustworthy person. When I was selling to restaurants on the street, I wanted to be the person they called first for any kind of question they had anytime. Call me. I'll call you right back. If I don't answer, I'll call you right back. And we'll get you the information you need. This could be the single biggest thing you could do in shifting your approach and adding value to the business relationship. A couple other quick things. These two go together, these next two. One, don't run out of stock. once you've sold in a product, you must immediately go, if you're a supplier, you need to go check with the distributor on their inventory. If you're a distributor rep, of course, you're going to be have better access to what's in inventory. But you need to watch it like a hawk. Because restaurants don't have a lot of storage, as I mentioned earlier, they're going to need to order frequently. And so you can't, neither party, the buyer or the seller, can assume that the product's going to be available. You must watch it like a hawk. So don't run out of stock. This is very damaging. When a restaurant starts having success with something, they like to keep it going. And running out of stock is a painful thing. Think of it this way. Running out of stock on one of your products is tantamount to sending their customer across the street. Now, it's doubtful that the restaurant across the street has the exact same product that you just ran out of stock. But that's the mentality you have to have. That's how hurtful it is to a restaurant when you let them run out of stock. You're asking their customers to leave the restaurant and go to their competitors. That's the way you need to look at it. And the thing that goes hand in hand with this is delivering the product at the quoted price. So many people think that you need to lower the price to make the sale. I have a video on that you should check out called Lowering the Price to Make a Sale is for Cowards. You should definitely check that out. Because if you're providing good service and good value and you're offering a fair price, then there's no need to lower the price to make the sale. But once you quote a price, you need to make darn sure that it gets delivered at that price. Not a penny more, not a penny less. And that is a sign of professionalism. And that's going to take follow-up on your part. So don't run out of stock. Deliver it at the quoted price. This is a fabulous way to add real value to the business relationship. And the last thing, which should go without saying, but it's shocking how many people don't do this, be a customer of that restaurant. When you have opportunity to dine or entertain, whether it's personal or business, go to that restaurant, especially before and after making a sale. Show them that there's no better way to show a restaurant that you care about their business than to become a customer yourself. So I hope those tips about adding real business value are helpful to you, and I hope you start practicing them. In closing, let me just wrap up by saying the key to selling your wine or spirit brand to a restaurant, believe it or not, is really not about the product per se. And yet so many people out there in the marketplace are attempting to make a sale by talking about the attributes of their product. I have news for you. Your product is not so distinct that some restaurant has to carry it. There are a few exceptions. There are certain brands that restaurants just must carry on the back bar and on the cocktail menu and on the wine list and by the glass. There are certain brands that they're going to do that for. But the real key to selling wine and spirits to restaurants is not about the product. As I've already mentioned in this video, it's more about service and dependability and trust and respecting the buyer's time and keeping your focus narrow and all the other things that I mentioned. So I hope this video is useful to you in opening up your mind to what you thought it took to be successful selling to restaurants is in reality very, very different. And you can start putting these things into practice right away. Hope this video is useful. If you like it, please click thumbs up, feel free to share it, and don't forget to subscribe. We'll talk to you soon.